So, hello student. So in the recurrence tree method, we are going to take another example. That question has already come into the AKTU examination. I'm going to tell you that this is a very simple one, but the beginner may get confused. Ka is equals to, suppose we are dividing a problem, recurrence relation is equals to T alpha n plus 1 T of 1 minus alpha n. T of 1 minus alpha n plus, the equation is plus n. T of 1 minus alpha into n. Right? This equation is, one second, I will take the look. Question. T of a n alpha 1 minus alpha plus n. Right? This is the equation. So, this questions may appear that we have to solve this problem using recurrence method, and in the single look it may appear a little bit different than the normal equation of recurrence. But there is a very simple, this is a very simple question. In this question, when a problem of size Tn is dividing, we are dividing the problem into problem of size T alpha n and a problem of size problem T1 minus alpha. Okay, alpha n and sorry n. So here we are dividing the problem of size n into alpha, problem of size alpha n into 1 minus of alpha n. So if we keep on dividing this problem, this will further divide like this, T of alpha into alpha n and T of alpha into 1 minus alpha n, and here this problem would divide into T of first would be 1 minus alpha into alpha n and T of 1 minus alpha square n, right? And likewise this will keep on dividing, and the simple procedure of recurrence tree is to calculate the sum of the cost of division, dividing the problem into sub problem at each level. Here the only difference is that initially the problem input size was n, and we divided into two partitions. One is the alpha n portion came to this side and another into 1 minus alpha n side. So when we keep on dividing, we have to calculate the cost at each level. So here the cost is, suppose I am using the term cn, a constant term I am using the simply depend upon, because the cost associated with is equals to n, simply I write n. Now here the cost is equals to alpha n plus 1 minus alpha into n, and that's equals to alpha n plus n minus alpha n, that's equals to n, right? The cost here is equals to n, the cost here is equals to n, and here at this level the cost is equals to alpha into alpha square n, this one, alpha into alpha n minus alpha square n, and here plus alpha n minus alpha square n, and here 1 n, sorry, n and plus alpha square n and minus 2 alpha n. So the cost at level 2, cost at level 2 is equals to this one. Here this term and this term will cancel each other, alpha n and minus 2 alpha n, minus 2 alpha n and alpha n cancel each other, minus alpha square n plus alpha square n cancel each other. The only term we are left with is equals to n. So the cost of this level is also equals to n. So in this way it shows that at each level the cost of dividing the problem into smaller subproblem is equals to n. So the final cost would be equals to the length of the cost of each level. Then how up to
how much extent it will go further. So to decide that, we have to take a look at these terms. Here, I am just rubbing this part. Here, there are four terms, alpha square n. Here, alpha into 1 minus alpha s n. Here also 1 minus alpha into alpha n. And last one is 1 minus alpha square. Here, you may see that this terms is alpha is a certain portion of it, and each time we are taking square of every term, which terms is most dominating. Suppose something which will finish up first, this term is reducing every time 1 minus alpha of square ratio, because suppose here that first term was 2. After that, you divided it into 1 upon 2 square. 1 upon 2. So, when you keep on dividing the larger portion through the function, that function will exhaust first. So, here among these functions, 1 minus alpha of the portion is reduced at each level. So, this will exhaust first. So, the height would be equals to log of 1 upon 1 minus alpha into n. Because one each level, for initially it was n, it next level it became 1 minus alpha into n, in the next level it is 1 minus alpha square into n. So each time, because 1 minus alpha would be a smaller number smaller than 1, and when we square a small, suppose the number is 0.2 and we square that number, means 0.04, that terms reduces faster than the other terms. So this term will reduce faster than this portion. So the height of the tree would be depend upon this terms. So the height would be equals to log n base 1 upon 1 minus alpha. Because this term will be, this will exhaust first. So nearly the height would be in, so the cost would be equals to n into log of 1 upon 1 minus alpha into n. But here we can take a lower bound to make it simple. We can simply assume that this is equals to log of n order. This is not the exact one. This is the, we are taking the value 2. So that would be much smaller than that. So it would be the bound on the close bound on that function that is bounded by the, to simplify it, the overall cost of this function would be equals to the n log n. So that would be the complexity of this recurrence, this function through the recurrence method. Okay. So I am just taking one more example for the one more example to solve this problem. So I am taking. So another example is Tn is equals to, suppose I am dividing it 2 Tn by 2 into n. Either simple, very simple question. Huh? So first you understand the simple question to revise all these things. So here the problem would be Tn. It would be divided into the 2 sub problem of size Tn by 2. And these problem will be further divided into 2 sub problem of size Tn by 4, because n divided into half of it. So n by 2 will be divided into half of it, it would be n by 4, right? And similarly, it will also be divided into Tn by 8. Right, and so on, and this process will continue till we are left with the single element. At that state we would halt. Suppose but we don't know at what height it would stop. So we can check that the term is n, then n by 2, then n by 4, then n by 8, and so on. So this can be represented as n upon 2 raised to the power 1, then n upon 2 square, n upon 2 cube, and so on. Suppose the height is equals to n upon 2 raised to the power I. At this level it become equals to 1, like we have done it already. So n upon 2 raised to the power I becomes 1. So 2 raised to the power I becomes n. So taking log both side, taking log base 2 on both side, so I is equals to log n base 2, right? So that would be the height. Okay, in this question we shall calculate the cost at each level. So here height would be equals to log n base 2. So the cost at each level, at this level cost would be equals to n, at this level cost would be equals to n by 2 plus n by 2, means n at this level cost would be n by 4 plus n by 4 plus n by 4 plus n by 4, that would be also equals to 1, and so on till the length of the tree, which is equals to log n base 2 into I. So the total complexity would be sum of all these terms. Okay, so when I add all these value, I am rubbing this part, okay, would be the sum of this one, all these terms would be added. So the final complexity Tn would be equals to n plus so on up to the n raised to the power, sorry, n last terms log 2n times, right? So the final sum would be n plus n log n base 2 times. So the final would be equals to n into log n base 2, or we can say that n log n. So Tn would be equals to n log n. So when you take a look at this, this is basically a binary tree like structure. So the total cost would be, complexity would be equals to n up to log n times, n log n times. So it would be equals to n log n. So in this way recurrence we can solve it very easily. That's all about it. Thank you.